Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with the scenario-independent quick missions. The next mission at hand is Mission Boot Camp, which takes place in Central Asia, 1530 hours. The weather conditions for change are light rain. I mean, it's raining lightly over in the mission area. Satellite imagery has revealed a nearby terrorist training camp. Make a pre-emptive strike against the facility and eliminate all hostile forces. That's pretty much it. So, I suppose we'll head into the briefing. I mean, from the looks of it, all these quick missions have their own concurrent theme ongoing. Because, like, if you take a look at missions all the way from, I think even Deception, from Holiday until, like, Jailbreak, you've got, like, Hostage, even Sudden Impact and Motorcade for that instance. All five missions were, what do you call them, hostage rescue scenarios, but taps onwards it has turned into what seems to be assault scenarios. So yeah, here we are at boot camp, a simple assault mission, eliminate everybody at a terrorist base.
Satellite reconnaissance has discovered a terrorist training facility east of the border. Command has authorized a preemptive strike against the facility. Proceed to Objective Monarch and eliminate all hostile forces. Bravo will insert from the northwest and lead the attack. Alpha and Charlie teams will take up positions at the perimeter and wait for Bravo to move in. The camp consists of three main training courses. Assault each course and take out the mercenary commanders first to prevent organized resistance.
I see, so basically we have to get in there and take out all the leaders first. Now, from the looks of it, there aren't really a lot of people that could possibly get in our way, because we will be taking the mountain passes primarily. This is one guy near the, the insertion point, which might be a problem, which is most likely going to be a problem, but there's a long hike to the base, and there are people around us. Taking a sniper, I feel, would be beneficial. However, there are lots of people at the base, and I think for this mission I would like to take the grenade launcher. They are recommending the sniper though. There's also a car there, so I don't know whether it is going to be a part of the action, but I suppose it's not, otherwise they would have recommended a law. However, the recommendations aren't always good, because there are times when, well, like for example, Mission Motorcade, they started off with recommending the saw, which was completely useless for that mission. But in this case, I think I would be okay with the grenade launcher, because in the end we do have to clear out everybody.
Bravo, this is King 6. The officers are primary targets.
Alpha team, moving in.
So my question is, how do we differentiate the officers?
King 6, this is Alpha 1. We've got a platoon in sight. I see one officer.
My question is, how do we differentiate the officers from the non-officers? Are they like wearing hats or something? I would hope that this game has made appropriate changes to the character models for differentiation. Would they have mustaches or something? Very important questions indeed. We're just going up this hill for now, but this is not our actual target. Oh boy, there's like an entire army running down there from the looks of it. I guess those are the people who are a part of the training camp then. And we essentially continue up this hill. There are patrols to my left as well, which I would prefer to avoid, being the reason why I'm straying a little from deviating a bit from the path. I'll take this feature on the right and then climb back up the hill. I don't want to alert anybody that doesn't need to be alerted to my presence until it cannot be helped, is what I mean. They should not be noticing me so easily, but well, you never know. We still have a ways to go, apparently. Yeah, it is like a long hike, from what I remember. But then again, we don't really need to announce our presence to just everybody. Might as well start heading this way, because that is where the game wants us to go. Well, not this way, but this way rather. Let me just take a knee here and yeah, set course to check one delta. Set as my waypoint. Right. Closing the map again. That is where we need to go. The waypoint markers in this game are better than the first game, but they aren't always all that good either. If you solely rely on the waypoint markers, I've been spotted. Amazing. But so yeah, if you rely solely on the waypoint markers, that will not really get you too far. Oops, I was trying to take out the officer with one bullet, but I ended up firing five instead. And yeah, we just need to take out the officers first. Of course, taking out everybody would be the preferred alternative, but officers first. Because that's how it goes in the military. And thus far I've got no issues sniping folks up, so might as well continue with the trend that we have set thus far. Oh, didn't see that wash out there. Nice to meet you. Hope you liked eating bullets. Well, that was a 2-for-1. Amazing. And are they still to my right? Yeah, there are like a few folks here. With weapons at that. And and that's a few folks down. A fair few folks down, in fact. Not just a few folks. Quite a few folks. Didn't see you there, you were quite well camouflaged with the rest of the snow.
There's a lot of bad guys in the camp. Too many for direct assault.
I mean, that is how things are supposed to be, right? Lots of bad guys in the camp. Oh, that's Charlie One. Okay, I was about to shoot you. Charlie One. Lima Charlie. I wonder what that means. LC. And apparently there are two folks to right over there. To my right, towards my right. Now this, while Charlie actually says that, I don't think there are as many folks as Charlie thinks there are in this camp. But yeah, we ultimately do need to clear out all the buildings. Two folks to my right. Do I have artillery? Of course I do not. No artillery authorizations. Authorization for artillery missions. And there you guys are. Somebody over there, huh? I see. And you guys. This time it's your turn to die. Apparently some more folks here. Inside these tents, no doubt. So, for that, I have a solution. Well, that was too far. Sorry. I've got a grenade each for you guys. And we just killed the commander. And the rest of the camp should be in a comparative disarray for a period of time. To which, to where we can capitalize and kill the rest of these infants without remorse. Execute order 66. Can you like die, or are you like that one Jedi who does not die? That is a 2-for-1. Good. Whoops. Here, grenade launcher. That ought to take care of anybody inside those tents. Like that guy over there. And his buddy somewhere nearby. Anybody there? Can't really make anybody out over there. But in case there's somebody hiding behind that truck, let me just go ahead and blow it up. Now, I'll save the rest of the grenades for clearing out the actual buildings themselves. But thus far, pretty straightforward mission. I hope it remains that way. I hope none of these guys are...
This is Charlie One! We're compromised! Move in!
Really, Charlie One is the one that's compromised, huh? I thought it was Bravo 1 that got compromised when those guys started shooting at me. So yeah, there are folks standing all over the place. I see. They're like... Everybody's like... completely surrounded me. Is what's going on. Okay, somebody's shooting at me. I can't tell who it is. Is that a person there? Yes, that is. Yes, that is. So... take out the officers. Enemies become dumb. Got it. And I do not believe I see any more enemies. Should I move? Sure. I guess we were supposed to get rid of all the enemies along the way then. It sort of reminds me of that quote. It's not the destination, but the friends you... it's not the treasure that's important, it's the friends that you made along the way that are... yeah, it sort of makes me say... it's not... the officers that are important, it's not the base that is important, but rather the enemies that we made along the way that are. yeah, my sense of humor is a little bad. Lots of enemies, yes, but most of them have been taken out. I hope. I was actually about to check that side anyway. Those guys did me a favor by exposing themselves. Which is, I have to thank them for it. It was pretty good on them. Is that an enemy? No, just a snowmobile. Somebody in one of those containers, probably. Oh, there you are.
King 6, Alpha 1, all primary targets destroyed.
Really? I thought
Bravo,
I would
finish
have to...
the job and take out the base.
Okay, how do I do that? Eliminate all mercenary commanders at Objective Monarch. Eliminate all hostiles at Objective Monarch. Are they all really dead? I thought there would be more. But my god, the amount of corpses that we've put... that we've placed around this damn base. And what did they do? What was their fault? Just picking the wrong side? And most of these people were probably kidnapped from impoverished villages anyway. Did we really have to kill them? Could we have not, like, captured them or something? Yikes. Delta Force, huh? I'm just taking a tour of all the premises, don't mind me. Ooh, I like the sound, you know? The sound effects in this game. Ever since the first game, like, if an explosion occurs a little too close to you, your ears will start ringing. And I feel like that's a lifted little detail that they've added. Let's go up. Up into the sniper's nest. I was hoping there would be a few snipers for me to take out, but no, it was just... folks who train. I wonder how much that raised my kill count by. Anyhow. King 6 is about 1. All enemies have been eliminated. The objective is secure. Over and out. And that was that for Mission Bootcamp. A pretty straightforward, pretty simple mission. I don't know whether it was simple because I avoided all those hostiles initially and started eliminating them later once I actually mounted an offensive on the base. I didn't actually realize that they, apart from the... how do I put it? Enemy patrols, there would also be commanders on the field training enemies all over the place. But yeah, I don't know what they would have done if they would have saw me either, because when I played the demo, I remember there being only 2 levels that you could play, and one of them involved a similar training camp, but the time was evening, and they were all running in ranks and files, and I didn't know what to do with the game back then, so I just used to join them and start running alongside them like an idiot. And yeah, none of the enemies were programmed to react to me either, so which made me think that, you know what, maybe these guys are actually my friends. So, anyhow, this was this, this was that, this was it for Mission Bootcamp. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Swamp Rat. Until then, well, take care, fare thee well, fellow things.